आफ्टरनून ऑल, प्रिंसिपल सर, एचओडी मैम, पूनम फलदो मैम एंड डियर फैकल्टीज एंड स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज वेबिनार टॉपिक ऑन डाइव इनटू फ्यूचर ऑफ एक्सआर, दिस इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय हर्ष बंसल सर. आई इनवाइट यू हर्ष बंसल सर, प्लीज स्टार्ट दिस सेशन.
या थैंक यू मैम फॉर अ काइंड वेलकम. सो I, Harsh Bansal, am founder of August Technologies, which is in Bengaluru. So let me get back to the to the presentation. Like, let's dive into XR. Like, what is XR and how people are using it into your daily life. So let's get into it. Like, many people knows that AR and VR are right now is a booming technology. Like, but what is actually AR and what is actually VR? Like, people are not knowing that thing. So let's start this session. So what is AR? Like, first of all, I will let you know, like, what comes into XR. XR is a combination of AR, VR and MR, that is augmented reality, virtual reality and mixed reality. So augmented reality is a concept where you used to see images, videos, then text, then 3D models, everything into a real world wherever you are able to see. Like, if you know about Iron Man, so Iron Man, what Iron Man is doing is whatever things he used to transfer from one place to another, he used to do that from his fingers, from his hands. So everyone has seen the Iron Man, right? All the Marvel fans here in the university. So everyone has seen that Iron Man. So that is the concept of mixed reality. AR, for an example, if you guys remember that 4 years ago, there is one game came into boom, that is in all over the world. So Pokemon Go, I'm talking about. So what the concept of Pokemon Go is, you can see the Pokemon in front of you on your table, on your bed, on the road, wherever you are passing from, in the ground and everywhere you can see the Pokemon. So that is AR. Then VR, everyone knows about VR. What is VR? Like, it is a technology where you used to wear a headset and see and get into the 3D world. So let's get into it. Like, this is a brief introduction I have given you about all these three technologies, that is AR, VR and XMR, which is a combination of XR. So let's get into it. Virtual reality. So if you guys see that whenever you type virtual reality in on a Google, you will get a complicated definition by a Wikipedia, that is this virtual reality is an interactive computer generated experience taking place into the simulated environment. It incorporates mainly auditory and a visual feedback, but may also allow other types of sensory feedback like haptic. This, I would say, like, this definition seems a bit complicated, right? Like, in a normal language, people don't understand what this definition mean to say. Like, normal people will not understand what is exactly the VR is. So let me show you my definition. What I have created is, that is, virtual reality means computer generated environment for you to interact with and be immersed in it. So what this definition is, I guess it is simple to understand, right? Like, it is a computer generated environment, like the environment with the 3D models and with lightings and interactions, like whatever the enemies and all. If you're creating a game, we generate that 3D environment and we interact into that, like with a controller, that is VR controllers if we are having. So with that VR controllers, we interact with them, like taking one object from one place to another. If you are playing a fire game or a shooting game, then with that controller you can fire the enemies and get immersed into it. Like, you will feel like you are inside that application only, you are inside that world only. So this is what VR means. Now let's get into the augmented reality. So this is the same definition. When you type on the Google, you will get to know this complicated definition in the Wikipedia. So what is it about like augmented reality is an interactive experience of a real world environment where the objects that reside in the real world are augmented by computer generated perceptual information, sometimes across multiple sensory modalities, including visual, auditory, haptics, sensor. Well, the word is also not like readable and olfactory. This definition I would say is more complicated. Like पता नहीं उन्होंने क्या सोच के ये डेफिनेशन बनाई है, फॉर हुम दे हैव क्रिएटेड दिस डेफिनेशन. ओके, सो लेट मी टेक यू टू द माय डेफिनेशन. व्हाट आई हैव क्रिएटेड इज दैट इज ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ यूजिंग टेक्नोलॉजी टू सुपर इम्पोज द इंफॉर्मेशन सच एज साउंड, इमेजेस एंड टेक्स्ट ऑन द वर्ल्ड वी सी. ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी एज द रियलिटी यू वुड ऑर्डिनरीली सी रादर देन रिप्लेसिंग इट. This seems simple. Okay, so means you can understand by this like what actually in a simple words the augmented reality means. This is the same thing I have written which was there in the Google definition, but in a simple words. So what is augmented reality? That we can see the images, sounds and text of the world in our real world, which we superimpose with our real world along with the occlusion and all. Like if you are having a 3D model which is placed behind the chair, then you can't see that model behind the chair because the chair is in front of that model. So if you take another angle, you can able to see that thing. So that is superimpose information into the real world. So now, what is the difference between AR and VR? This is the main thing, like I would say, when our students get into this technology, developing the technology into AR and VR, they come across these things like what is the difference? What is the main difference between that? What are the things which we should keep in mind by building the AR applications and VR applications? So let's see that it is a fully enclosed reality. So that's true. Like whenever you are wearing a headset, that is if you are see the headsets like Oculus is there, HTC Vive is there, then Samsung Gear is there, Google Cardboard and all. So whenever you wear that headsets, the reality is totally enclosed. You won't be able to see what is happening in the real world, right? And in augmented reality, it is partially enclosed. You can see the real world and also the created world. Then synthetic experience with no sense of a real world. Yeah, the same thing what I said, that you won't be getting a sense of what is happening in the real world, and real world remains central to the experience enhanced by the virtual details. Yeah, whatever I said, the same thing. Now another is not having see through the capabilities. Okay, so like if you are wearing the headsets, like if we are talking about the headsets, particular headsets in AR and VR. So in VR headsets, we are not capable enough to see through the objects into the real world. While if we are talking about the augmented reality headsets, like that is the HoloLens, Magic Leap, then Google Glass. So with these headsets, we can see the real world also from the lenses, like what is happening, and also the augmented things are projected with the projector lens. So this is the main difference. And then requires wearing a VR headset or additional equipment to get fully immersed into the experience. Yeah, so only requires a AR compatible smart device to enjoy the experience. True. So like for experiencing a VR, you need a headset, and if it is an interactable application like any fighting game or any shooting game or any interactable one, so you need a controller also for that. Like just only headset will not work, you need a controller, VR controller also for that thing. But in AR, whenever you are building an AR experience, you just need a AR enabled smartphone, that is Android and iOS. So in Android also there is a few smartphones which are enabling AR, and in iPhone almost all the iPhones are having a support of AR. So that is the required. So now, what technology usage, like this technology use will be in which field, you can say, like what type of applications we can create, in which domain we can create the applications of AR and VR using this technology. So one is the education, then second is archaeology, architecture, business, marketing, games, medical, e-commerce. So let's see in detail, like how we can use this technology in this particular domains. So, and yeah, and now the platforms, the main thing where we can start building the AR applications, like from which platforms are required for building an AR applications, which SDKs are required. So there are many platforms available, like many IDEs are available right now in on the market, that where we can create an AR applications. All have their pros and cons. So the main thing, the main I would say famous platform where developers used to create AR and VR games is games and applications both are Unity 3D, then Unreal Engine, Godan, Blippar, Roar, Ketchum, Augment, HP Reveal, Reflect One, Unite AR, and Sketchfab. So these are the platforms where people used to develop their AR and VR applications majority of the times, and like it is some of the applications, like some of the platforms are giving a drag and drop facilities as well. Like if the students who are not knowing coding and who don't want to do coding, so they can use that platform and they can develop their AR VR applications, but that will be the basic one only. Obviously for creating an application or any of the application, coding is required, and the coding is the main thing where you can do more interaction with them. Like with the drag and drop, you can just do some of the things, just a basic, just you can see a model in front of them, and also more than that, you can just animate as a rotation and a translation. That's all. No, nothing can be done in that. So yeah, SDKs. What are the SDKs and what is SDK? Is the software development kit, which is a support, I would say, for creating an AR VR applications. So that support is given by a few of the companies, and they have created their own SDKs. That is the software development kit, where using that SDK, you can create your own application with any of the platforms we have seen previously. So let's see which are the SDKs are this. Vuforia is there, then Google AR Core, Google AR Kit, Apple AR Kit, then SLAM, Wikitude, Facebook AR Studio, and AR Foundation. So Vuforia is one of the first I would say that SDK, AR SDK, which has been started along with a support of image tracking. Like now also the image tracking is best of Vuforia. If you want to create an image tracking based application, then I would prefer to go with Vuforia, because it is giving a best tracking experience. The feature points, the whatever image you are uploading, it is taking from the cloud. So that is the best SDK, I would say, for creating an image tracking AR application. Then Google AR Core and Apple AR Kit are the one of the, I would say, mainly used SDK right now for plane tracking. Then for any, like, mainly people are using the plane tracking most of the time for their application building, because with the plane tracking we can keep the object anywhere on the plane, and after that we can play with that object as much as way we want. So AR Kit and AR Core is there. Then Facebook AR Studio is also one of the very nice platform, I would say, like SDK, which is like only available for iOS right now. Android support is not there, but yeah, developing application and iOS application with the Facebook AR Studio is one of the best, I would say, for the face tracking part. Like you can see the filters and all, whatever the filters that you can see in Snapchat, then Facebook, then Instagram. So you can create that type of a filter very easily with that. For that, I forgot to keep the platforms in that. Like platforms like Lens Studio is there for the Snapchat, and Spark AR is there for this Facebook one. So these two platforms are also there. If you guys are noting, then you can just add these two platforms into the list. That is, one is the Lens Studio, that is for Snapchat, and another is Spark AR, which is for the Facebook filters. So, and then lastly, AR Foundation. The AR Foundation is the one of the best, I would say, for AR applications. AR foundation is a combination of AR core and AR kit. So like if you are creating any application, like AR application, you don't need to use separately. Like for Android, you don't have to create separate application with AR core and with AR kit. So if you are creating an application for both Android and iOS, then you can start development with the AR foundation, and you don't need to do a separate coding for both Android and iOS. Like it is a cross platform, so you just need to switch your platform and you can deploy your application on iOS and Android both using the AR foundation. So let's go ahead. So let's start with AR, like types of experiences. So as we have seen the usage of AR, like if you remember before, yeah, here. So where we can use the technology AR, in which domains we can use. So let's see that into a detail, like in which domain we can see that. So let's start with it. So AR for shopping and retail, like right now everyone is doing online shopping, right? So what if we create an application of each and everything, like there is a clothes application, watch application, jewelry, then everything, whatever you purchase into your day-to-day life, we can create that application into AR. So first point, that is for the purchase of a clothes. Yeah, that's true. Like if you want to purchase a clothes, now what if your own 3D model come in front of you and you can try the clothes on that, and you can experience that thing on your own body, and you can see like which cloth will be looking good on your body, whether this will be looking good or not. So the same thing can happen if you are going in any of the stores you are going, then you can save your time of a trial room as well. Like without going to a trial room, you can check, like ladies are there, like no offense, but yeah, ladies are there, so they need to check their sari and whatever clothes they are having. So they, like if they like 10 clothes of that, but they won't be trying each and every 10 clothes into the trial room, it will take a lots of time for it. So what if they check that into a AR, that how it will be looking on their body, and after that whichever they feel good, like from the 10 they can select one or two, and after that they can try that into the trial room. So that will save a time, and also they will get a new experience in AR, like how the dresses can see there on their own body. Like they can check millions of dresses, lakhs of crores of Arab of dresses on their body without taking a trial. So that's the one good thing. And now another point, that is a purchase of a furniture, like as a decor. If you see, IKEA is a one company who is having their decor application, and many other companies are there, but the IKEA is the very famous company who is giving a decor solution. And what this application is doing is, like, you need to just scan your floor and the 3D model of a particular furniture, like a sofa, lamp, table, bed, then cabinet, everything will be coming, and you can just adjust that into your room there, and with you can change the colors also, like how this application will be looking, and how you will be able to experience that furniture into your room. So you can see that thing by your eyes, that that particular chair is looking good, that particular table, that particular sofa is looking good, and you can add into the cart and order it, or else you can set a meeting with a company and go there and just have a look in the personal, and you can bring that at our home. Second is online food ordering. As you know that online, Zomato, Swiggy are the two competitor companies who are running in online for the food ordering. So what if we can give a solution to them for an AR food, like whatever you order from a Swiggy. So you, like, let's say you ordered veg Manchurian and you ordered dosa, but you want to see that what is the quantity of a Manchurian, how the dosa will be looking. So you will tap on that AR option, and that Manchurian bowl will come in front of you, and you can see that how much quantity they are giving, what is the ingredients they are having, and what is the cost of that Manchurian. So like everything you can able to see that in AR. The same thing in dosa, that how the dosa will be looking, what curry they will be having, what is the ingredients, what is the masala of a dosa they are having inside it. So you will get to know that how this thing will be, how that food will be looking, and how much nutrition, calories, and that healthy details will be also given. So you will get to know that whether to order this or not, and the costing of that particular food is also given. So you will get everything like a 3D menu, I would say, in front of you of that food. Now the same for the watches, like as you can see here in the image, came on his phone and he is seeing that how that watch is looking. Same for the jewelry, you are having a front face, and whenever you move around your face, you can see the jewelry as a necklace, then earrings, then nose pins, and then all the jewelries, yeah, like necklace and earrings, that kind of thing in business. Okay, so how AR is compatible with the business, like what type of business AR can give, that is I would say house navigation, that is indoor navigation, like not house navigation, I would say it can be a hotel, then a university, then any of the place, like a shopping mart is there, like a D-Mart, Big Bazaar, like it's a big stores where you need to find some particular things. So there, if we are having an AR application, so if you tap on the button of first, let's say we are talking about a shopping mart, so we are in a D-Mart, then we are in a Big Bazaar. So if we want to purchase a fruits, so we'll select from the menu that I need to select the fruits, that apple is there, orange is there, banana is there, and after that the AR camera will open and a virtual guide will come in front of you and will show you that how you can go towards this fruits, and what will be the path of reaching towards the fruits, that is apple, banana, oranges, and if you select vegetables, then from there what will be the path of a vegetable, you will also get to know that thing. So like the guide, that virtual guide will be guiding you from all over the shopping mart, wherever, whatever things you are required for. The same thing will be the 3D space architectural design for the constructions. Yes, so like if any real estate property is there, and like you are having a 3D, you are creating a 3D house for them. So for a walkthrough, you can see the people will get an experience that how the house will be looking in a real world with that 3D models, lighting, texturing, and everything. You can walk inside that house, you can experience that house, that how this will be looking after the construction has been completed. So that will help the realtors and real estate people to give an AR solution prior the building has been created. So that will give them a good experience, and that will also catch good buyers also to them. Another is using a HoloLens can do repairing work from one corner of the world to another. Yeah. So HoloLens, as you know, that the Microsoft has created an AR glass, that is a HoloLens, which is giving a world, which is connecting people from one corner of a world to another. So like as an example, I would say if you are sitting here and your daughter or anyone is staying there in any of the foreign countries, so like there is a need of a plumber, and you know that one of the guy near your house or here in India is a plumber, you are staying with them. So using a HoloLens, you can contact that person, and that person sitting here can guide you from in AR. He can show you that which nut or which bolt to fix so that the leakage will stop. Then same thing for the lift maintenance also, like the people who went for the lift maintenance part and the senior, and the senior engineer is sitting somewhere else. So using a HoloLens, he can virtually be present there and will show you that how, what things to be changed so that the lift can work properly. Then for the creation of bikes, automobiles and everything, for everything like this HoloLens is required. So you can, so by wearing a HoloLens, you will get a model of a car which you have designed right first, and after that with the HoloLens you can see that in front of you in AR, and if you feel like there is some changes to be required, then with the help of your hands, that is, it is doing a hand tracking part, so with the help of your hands you can shift that part from one side to another, and you can scale that part like you want to make it a big or you want to make it small. So that part can also be done with the HoloLens, so that you can give as much output what you are looking and what you are imagining into your mind. So that's the thing. So like, yeah, social media, like every day people are using AR, but none of them are knowing that this is augmented reality technology, is a Snapchat filter. So a Snapchat filter, then Instagram filters, then Facebook filters, Google stickers, Apple emoji. So this is all AR, which AR has came into the social media now. Slowly it will be coming in all the domain. Like the only one social media is there who have implemented AR and people have accepted that in India. In India, I'm talking about. Like in out of the India, people have accepted in all the domains AR. But India, as you know, that it is lacking behind 10 to 15 years from the other countries. So it will take time to adapt the AR in day-to-day life in every domain. But yeah, people have adapted that in a social media, which is also running a well. So Snapchat filter, Instagram filter, Facebook filters, all these filters are the example of AR. Then gaming. So first game in AR, which came was a Harry Potter game, which no one was knowing, but it doesn't exist because no one can able to play it and no one is that much aware of that application, and that game has been stopped. So after that, like, you can see the images of that Harry Potter, like this one, then this one, then this one. Yeah, so these all are the example of a Harry Potter AR game, so which is been deprecated. And after that, and the secondly, the game came was a Pokemon Go, which gave a lot of hype of AR to the students and to the players, like for the gamers who are playing this application. So like, this is all about AR gaming. Like, yeah, this is the Pokemon Go. You can see the Charmander, you can in front on the ground, and you just need to throw a ball on it and the Charmander will be yours. Then in education, yes, AR in education, like I would say not only AR, but VR into our education is also a very good thing. Like, if you are a medical people, if you are a medical student, then having a VR into your medical training is very much like I would say important. Like, let's take an example. So like, if you are training a doctors, so for training a doctors, VR is very much important, I would say, because that will give you a real experience that how you have to do the operation. Like any heart patient is there, so we will create an application where we are giving a training to the doctors who will be treating a heart patient, like how much part to cut, how much blood to take out of it, and like whatever the terminologies are there for the medical people. So that will show that how the operation should be conducted in VR. They will, so like for the medical institutes, it will be a very good thing that before giving a practical knowledge to them, they can have a virtual training in that particular field. So like, they can have a training in dentistry, they can have a training in the operation, they can have the training in surgery. So we'll create a virtual training session for them, and after that they can practice that in real. So that will give them an idea that okay, कि ये गलती मुझे यहाँ पे नहीं करनी है, ये गलती मुझे real में नहीं करनी है. So that's the thing. In then analyzing of a DNA, as I said, that yeah, for the medical part, like everything in the medical part can be done, chemistry, physics, maths, देन ट्रेनिंग एनवायरमेंट. या सो केमिस्ट्री फिजिक्स लाइक जो केमिस्ट्री के मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड ऑल होते हैं, वी कैन शो देम इन एआर एंड वीआर बोथ, लाइक व्हिच मॉलिक्यूल्स टू कनेक्ट मेक अ बॉन्ड विथ व्हिच मॉलिक्यूल्स सो दैट दिस रिएक्शन कैन हैपन. एंड द सेम थिंग फॉर द फिजिक्स, लाइक how much aerodynamics is required, how much speed and velocity should be given to an automobile, that how with what velocity the ball should be thrown, that all the physics concept we can show that in AR and VR both. So that is coming of the education. And nowadays like AR in education is taking a little bit more hype in India after the social media, because as you know that the children are nowadays very used to the gadgets like iPad. Many of the students you have seen at your home also, like if there is a kids, then they are all the time playing with mobile phones, iPad, like all these electronic gadgets. So the education has been shifted to this on these gadgets. Like there will be a book, like you can see here in the photo, there is a books of a monument, and with the help of AR, when you scan the book, you will be able to see the monuments into the real, that is a 3D model of that monuments will be coming. So this will give students and the kids a new experience, and which will give them smile as well on the face. They will be happy by this. So nowadays people in India are accepting education in AR more than the virtual. And like jo books wali reading hoti thi na, ke bhaiya A for apple liye hota hai, B for ball liye hota hai. So that is, people are avoiding that, and many of the companies are working on this AR education, and they are giving this type of a solution. So nowadays parents are teaching them that thing only with the AR. Like if you see A for apple, then that will be coming with some of the animation and with some of the characters that this is A for apple. So that will visualize students in a more better way. In a healthcare, as I say, yeah, see, I can, you can see here the medicines, then hospital training, brain analysis, hand tracking visualization. So here you will get to know, like a person is sleeping, then you will get an idea of this whole interior structure, like what is the bones, your heart and everything. And you will get to know, like for this particular treatment, for this particular surgery, which part to cut first, which part not to cut, and how, what precautions should be taken, so that you can see that in front of you wearing a HoloLens or wearing a AR wearing any of the AR headsets and the VR headsets. And in the down figure, you can see like that person has done his brain analysis. Then he can see that in which part of his brain there is an issue, or if I'm not wrong, he's checking the day-to-day analysis of his brain. Like on the first day, this brain is working that way. On the second day, the brain is working this much better way. So I guess that is the thing. So this is how like AR will be coming into the future, that in treatment in hospitals. So they will be implementing in the real time operation part as well. How AR works? So let's see it. As we have talked about AR, ki bhaiya AR mein apne ye kar sakte hai, wo kar sakte hai. We have seen all the possibilities of AR, but how it actually works. So for enabling AR, you need two things, that is accelerometer and a gyroscope, which is there nowadays in all the phones, that is in all the Android and iOS, both phones, accelerometer and gyroscope is available. So motion tracking can be done in AR with that. After that, for enabling a motion tracking, what you need is the camera, accelerometer, gyroscope, and for the location base, what you need is magnetometer and a GPS. GPS is already there in all the phone. Accelerometer and gyroscope is also there. Camera is also there, and magnetometer is now coming in new recent phones. Like magnetometer is also there in previously, but not in all the phones it is there. So location based AR is not possible in every phones. So these two things are there. Now what are the features of AR? The one thing, placing and positioning of assets means the 3D models what we are using into our day-to-day life, not day-to-day life, what we are using into the application. So placing and positioning, that is, if you can see, there is a coffee cup, you can, there is a one circle on the coffee cup, that is the position point of that coffee cup. And once you move that coffee cup, you can move it anywhere in the world. Then the scaling, the asset. So scaling the asset means not that you need to make it big and small. It is the scaling means once you place the object like this here, you can see there is a pizza piece. You have placed this object here, and when you go near the object, you will see that object there only. Like ye pizza piece ko yahan pe rakha. So at the distance, you can see that a pizza piece is small, but once you go near to it, it will get big. So that is the scaling of asset. That is, scaling means not from doing a big and small thing. Like for example, like scaling of asset example I give, whenever you are going on a highway, you can see the cars coming from cars ahead of you. There is a small thing, but when you speed up and you go near the car will be there in your actual size. So that is the scaling of assets means. Like you don't have to make it big or small by any functionality, but wherever you place that object, it will be placed there, and when you go near to it, it will be scaled automatically as a bigger one. Occlusion. So occlusion means how the object has been occluded with the real world. Like if I tell you that I'm having an example before. No. Okay. So if I tell you that this Android object I have kept below, but when I change the angle of my camera and when I take the camera above of it, so I won't be able to see this down Android model because it has been occluded with the table roof. So matlab agar real world mein apne dekhe ki koi apan ne object rakha hai table ke niche, बट जब अपने कैमरा टेबल के ऊपर लेके जाएंगे तो वो अपने को ऑब्जेक्ट नहीं दिखेगा नीचे कि वो रखा हुआ है कि नहीं, बिकॉज द टेबल इज ओपेक. सो द सेम वे दिस कैन बी हैपन नाउ इन एआर आल्सो. लाइक द 3D मॉडल विच यू हैव कैप्ड बिलो द टेबल, एंड व्हेन वंस यू टेक द once you change the angle of your camera and take it to the above of it, so you won't be able to see that the object has been placed down or not because of the occlusion, because of the opaqueness of the real world object. Like table is there in the real world and this Android model is in the non-real thing. So this is because of occlusion shader, I would say. So now the Unity has created an occlusion shader, and the AR Foundation has also created an occlusion shader which is working on this as a backend. Like if they detect any real world object which is opaque, they won't be enable the AR objects to come in front of that. Then another is the lightening of assets. So lightening also plays a very big role into AR. Like if you are placing any model and the lighting in a real world, like it is compatible with a real world lighting. You can change the lighting. Like if you are placing a model in front of a window, and when you turn off the lights and the window is open, so you can directly see the model is shining because of the sun rays. And once you close the window, the model will get dark. So that is the one plus point AR has been given. Then plane finding and the feature point. So before placing a AR model, you need to find a plane and the feature points so that you will get a plane surface, and after that you can place a model on it. So plane finding is there and a feature points is there. So you can see that circle like dots are there. So it is detecting a plane. Like a plane is detected with a feature points. That is, if you are placing any model on a plane surface, so that has to detect as much feature points. Like it won't be placed on a plane surface or a plane tile. Like if a marble is there with a white tile, there will be no feature points, no textures will be applied on that tile so that it will take a time to detect. But here in the image, you can see that there is that some of the textures applied on the wooden table. You can see that brown lines is there, and like that type of a textures is there. So that are called the feature points. So camera will detect that feature points, and they will detect a plane so fast instead of the plain surface, that is where is no texture is there. So yeah, so that and context awareness, as I said, like the for AR, that feature points and all are required, which like whatever I said till now is now written here in the text format. So let me read it out. That is, AR hardware has to be aware of essential every single objects in its environment. So yeah, that is the occlusion part, which I said that the AR environment will scan the whole real world wherever you are placing the object, and if there any opaqueness will be there, it will occlude that thing. It will not show the AR object in front of that opaqueness. It needs to understand that there is a desk, a chair and a table next to the bookcase and a vase and a television. Yeah, that is the understanding of a real world environment. It needs to know which of this item is taller, shorter and wider, and how it changes the subject around the space. So that is all bakwas which I have done before. I have explained to you everything. Generating this awareness quickly and without a drop in a digital object's fidelity, smoothness or functionality is one of the biggest challenge facing AR creators today. So yeah, as I said that you need to understand the AR environment first, like your application should understand first that application using a depth and a feature plane and the feature points, that wherever you are placing the object, at what distance it is from the camera, at what height it is, and what the hardware is taking from, like what your phone hardware is taking as an input to place that object. So you will, once you start developing the application, you will get to know, you will come across all these challenges, and you will be solving that as you will get into it more into more deep. Tracking in AR. So yeah, so how the tracking will be happening in AR, like whenever you are working with a headset or you are working with your devices. So how the tracking is there? So the process of scanning, recognizing, segmenting and analyzing the environment information is called a tracking in immersive technologies. So tracking means that only which I told you before, that you need to understand the environment, like what thing you are scanning, where you are placing the object, and what are the surrounding objects in the real world available so that you can place at that point or not. So in AR there are two types of a tracking, that is inside out tracking and outside in tracking. So inside out tracking, that is let's see with the image only. So what is like outside in tracking, sorry, not inside out, outside in tracking. So if you know about a glass, that is HTC Vive is there, Oculus Rift is there, then Oculus Quest is there. So what they create is we need to keep external sensors. Like here you can see the external sensors camera we need to keep, and we need to set up a whole AR room for that, like AR and VR room for that. So a particular space is required, and wearing a headset you can create that type of environment into the real world with a camera. So with that, once you start building the application, you have created the environment. So with the tracking of your real world flat surface, like 6x6 or 4x4, any of the room you can create. So you will be placing these cameras in front of that, and you, after wearing a headset, you will get to know, you will be able to see that all holographic models in front of you into that particular space of 6x6 or 4x4, how much dimension space you have created. So you will be able to see that thing, and you can interact with that into that place only. So the one thing, the drawbacks of that is you will be restricted to that particular place only. You can't portable from one place to another. It is not a portable device. Like you need to set up, portable is only possible when you take that whole 6x6 room along with you into your pocket, and that is not possible. So this is like outside in tracking is done in universities, in any of the industries, and where they used to provide a training to the trainers and students and faculties. and also like previously one head mounted, like the first head mounted device which was doing outside in tracking was Keo, that was doing the same wave, which like with the cameras of around 10 cameras they are required for building the whole AR room, and after that with that cameras they can see the holographic image, the 3D models in front of them inside out tracking is nowadays possible. Nowadays the AR headset which are coming is doing inside out tracking, that is wearing a headset, that is the HoloLens is there, Magic Leap is there, Google Glass is there, they are doing inside out tracking. Means inside out tracking means taking input from inside and throwing it outside into the real world. So we'll be creating an application and we'll deploy that application into their devices OS, that is operating system, whatever the device OS is there, and we'll show that in front of them. So it is also portable, it is also, you can carry it with your, in your bag, and you can take it wherever you want to, and once you want to see the AR experience you can wear that glass and see that experience. So in that they are having a light sensor, they are having a gyroscope sensor, then they are having a camera also inside it, so that if you want to do a recording of that thing you can do the recording also. So that is being possible with this inside out tracking headsets, that is AR headsets. So motion tracking has been done with a SLAM, that is so the general technology behind the motion tracking is called SLAM, and it is its full form is simultaneous localization and mapping. So this is a process by which technologies like robots and smartphones analyze, understand and orient themselves to the physical world. Yeah, so like this is the main thing which has been used by the robotics, like if you want to train a robot then and also the smartphone, like if you want to train a robot, that with the in the eyes of a robot there is a SLAM technology has been kept with they can do the motion tracking, and for that motion tracking they need an accelerometer and a gyroscope so that they can easily track the environment which is going around. So SLAM processes require data collecting hardware like cameras, depth sensors, light sensors, gyroscopes and accelerometers. Yeah, so like this all sensors and gadgets are required for detecting the SLAM, that is for collecting all the data into the SLAM, and so that they can do a proper motion tracking. So AR Core uses all this to create an environment. Yeah, as we have discussed before, AR Core, AR Foundation, then AR Kit for detecting the planes and feature points, everything is there. And COM is AR Core also uses a process called concurrent automatry and a mapping or call. So COM is not used now because it is not that much fruitful, because nowadays like people are using the AR for most of the time in a motion tracking and for detecting a feature points, like for detecting a feature points it is not used much. Like COM is mainly used for the feature points where you have to upload a data on a server, and then after that calling from a server the models will be loaded, so it is taking much more time. So now what people are using for this is they are using the Unity's asset bundle. So how Unity Asset Bundle is working will explain in the next webinar if we arrange it then. So yeah, so this is the Cloud Anchors what I'm talking about. So the Cloud Anchors, so how the Cloud Anchor is working, wherever you have placed the object, so that will the position of an object will be detected with the camera's depth sensor and the positioning points where the model has been kept. So from that they will be get to know that which point, what is the coordinates of a point that model has been placed, and that point has been loaded, that point has been saved on a server. And if you want to see that into any other mobile, so like if you are having a friend phone, the API will be called, the same application, the API will be called on your friend's phone, and your friend can see that same model on that same position only from his phone. So how it works is like you need to have a native anchor on a cloud. That is a native anchor means that a position, the native position that is from the user's phone, one phone position on the cloud, then create a cloud anchor, then cloud anchor ID should be shared. Yeah, so whatever the ID is generated, you need to just give that ID to your friend and he will be insert that ID and it will be resolved, and after that he can see the 3D model on that same point only. So think like an user, like what creating an application, what things you have to keep in mind. I hope till now whatever I have explained is being understood by everyone, by the faculty, students and everyone. So I hope I'm not taking it much faster and much slower, like the speed is moderate, I guess. Cool. Okay, so let's think that what should we before creating an application, before creating an AR application, what things we have to keep in mind so that the user, according to the user, we can create an application and the user will also get a benefit of that. User will also like our application. So first thing is you need to create a user experience and a UI that we need to have a best UI for the application, because UI will catch the user more better way. अगर तुम कोई भी application बना रहे हो तो वो अगर दिखने में अच्छी नहीं होगी then definitely you will not use it, because as a non-technical person or a technical person, they will see कि भैया हमें दिखने में कौन सी चीज अच्छी लग रही है, what is the good coming into our eyes. So for that UI is required. UI is a much important part, I would say, for any of the application and any of the software. Then basic AR interactions, will tell you what are the basic AR interactions later. Then 3D model should be low poly and a good looking. Yes, the size of a 3D model should not be much so that the your application size should not exceed. So like a general AR application should consist of around 25 to 30 MB. Agar uske upar ja raha hai, then you need to reduce the size of a 3D models. Then main functionality of a app, obviously, like what are the main functionality of a app, what according to the user requirement, according to the client requirement, you are needing it. So yeah, the basic interaction which we are talking about AR is what are the basic interactions, that is a drag and drop part. Then voice recognition, voice kind of a thing, like a beep or anything on any interaction, there should be some of the voice or some of the haptics we should keep. Then tapping, pinch and zoom, slide and translate, tilt. So let me explain this all. Basic interaction, drag and drop, matlab everyone knows like what is drag and drop, taking one object from one place to another, that is a drag and drop. Voice, I told you, tap means on a tapping on a screen, something should happen, the model should come on that tap at that position, at that point where we have tap on the screen. That is the basic operation. Pinch and zoom, with our two fingers by zooming, zoom out and zoom in should happen. Slide and translate, with our one finger we need to slide that 3D model, we can change the position of that 3D model. That are the basic interactions. Tilt means by tilting our phone device, the model should not change its position, the model should remain at that position only. So that thing should be kept in mind. Now let's talk about the headsets, like which are the headsets available and which headsets are used in the industries. So these are the virtual reality headsets. I will tell you that HTC Vive is there, Oculus Rift is there, PlayStation VR, Google Daydream View, Samsung Gear VR and Google Cardboard. The main I would say the main headsets for VR which are there in the industries, universities and what people are working on, which is the requirement of the industries now, like after graduation, if you are telling that in your resume you are an AR VR developer, so first thing your company will ask is which, okay, as you have mentioned that you are a VR developer, you are an AR developer, so on which headsets you have worked on which headsets you are having a knowledge of that. So you will get to know So they will first ask that, because nowadays whichever company is coming and they are getting into the AR VR domain, they are first working on that headsets because they need to provide a training to the big big companies, like any industry is there, any of the big companies is there. So for the industrial training, this VR is very much helpful. So they are taking students in this headsets only. So for that, this HTC Vive here on the right top, this is the HTC Vive with two controllers. Then here on the left bottom, there is Oculus Quest with two controllers. And here at the bottom right, there is a Google Cardboard. So Google Cardboard is a simple hardware, a simple VR headset where you just need to keep your phone inside it, and you can just watch a movie or anything. You can just watch a VR experience. That is the thing. Headsets for the AR. So this is also one of the very important AR headsets, like Microsoft HoloLens, then Magic Leap Lightwear, Google Glass, Meta 2. So here you can see on the top right, there is a HoloLens that has been by the Microsoft, which is giving a very one of the best AR experiences, MR experiences, I would say. Then here in the bottom, there is a Magic Leap headset, which is detecting, like it is capturing the data from our eyes retina. It captures our eyes retina, and whatever it is projecting out, it directly throws to our eyes retina, so that there will be no bridge between any of the lens or specs. Here in the HoloLens, if you are having a specs, you can wear a spec and directly, and with that spec also you can view that. But here in a Magic Leap, it will first detect like if you are having a specs, and if you are having a number like 6.5 or any of the numbers you are having on your eyes. So it will detect first, it will capture that data from the your cornea, from your retina, and after that it will show you the image projecting, so that without a specs also you can see that on a clearly with that vision. So that is the one of the good part of a Magic Leap. Then yeah, so whereas we have discussed that how we can create this thing and what are the things we need to keep in mind, so let's take you to the platform where we can create this application, that is a Unity platform, so that you can come to know a basic of the Unity, that how we can create this thing. So this is just like right now one of the project of mine opening is here. You can see this is a scene view where you can see whatever things you are being creating, what are the 3D models are there you are creating. So this is my 3D model of one house, I would say. So this is a scene view where you can see that all thing. Then here this is the hierarchy which you will get to know that what are the elements are there into your scene. So like whatever the scene there into your scene and which things are included in your application. So here this is the interior flat. So if I delete this, you can see that it has been gone from your scene. So you won't be able to see that from that it is not there now into the application. Control Z, I will get it back. So this is the hierarchy where you can see all your scene view. Then here this is the project window where you will get to know that what are the things available in your project, what are the assets are available into your project. So you will get to know that thing. And this is the game view. Like game view is the final where you will be able to see your application. Like if I move this camera, so you will get into this and you will get to know that how it will be looking, how is it looking. So this is the game view. Game view means your final camera view. Then here it is an inspector view. Inspector means whatever game object is there, you can do the changes in it. So here I have selected this flat. Then here inside this flat, if I go onto the wall slab, so here you will get to know all the properties of the wall slab. Here transform means the POGI of slab, like what is the position of the slab in X, Y, Z position, in rotation of it, like what is the rotation value, what is the scaling value, then which mesh and what material is attached to it. So we can do all the changes from here. This is from the inspector menu. This is the project settings. This is the lines. And this, I would say, is the console menu, where you will get to know of all the errors, whichever error are coming. So right now I'm not having any error, so you can see it as a blank one. But yeah, if you get any error, you will get to know that came. So this is all about Unity environment. Like, this is just a basic I have shown you. And yeah, so that's it, I guess. Yes, so that's all from my side. I guess we are running on time. And yeah, so for reaching us out, you can contact me anytime. This is my email ID. This is my personal number. This is my company number. You can contact on any of the company domain also. And this is our website link. So website is right now on the development. We are creating a website, that is, and also website we are creating is into a 3D website we are creating. So let me show you like a demo of that, like how 3D website we are creating. So I hope it will work. So it will be taking time to load. Internet connectivity is slow, I guess. So the 3D website, what we are creating is like, it will be a website where you will be able to see the 3D logo, not a 3D logo, but your office. Like for any of the company, we need to create a website. So it's a whole office space will be created in a 3D, and they will get to know that how office will be looking whenever whosoever client is visiting them. They will get to know that how the office is looking. And after that, there is a walkthrough given with all the voice and interaction with the people at a reception, so that they will come to know that how, what are the things and what are the what I say. Yes, now it will be loading. The server will take time, I guess. So yeah, let's end up here. It will.
On behalf of the computer department, sir, I extend very heartily vote of thanks to you. We truly appreciate the experts like you, and I must say that the session is very informative, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.